Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about how to make edits in Google Slides with the help of Google Apps Script. So for this, I'll go to my drive, I'll click on new and go to Google Slides and blank presentation. I have already created one, a blank presentation here, and I have a slide here in which I have some header, okay, and I also have a text box over on the left hand side. Now I want to change the text box. I'm going to explain how we can access this text here and can change the text with the help of Google Apps Script. So for this, I will go to Tools. I'll go to Script Editor. Okay, so I'll get this code page. I can write anything here. Like for example, let's change the function name, text box update. You don't have to be a full-time coder or expert coder to get your things done. Just make sure that you have to remember few things. For example, in this case, function, the name, these brackets and these brackets. Okay, you have to keep it as it is. You can change the text here. You can name it any function you want, but everything else should be same, right? Inside this function, I'm going to create the script which will edit the text box in this line. Okay, let's go to the editor. Cool. So as you know, in my previous videos I have explained that how Google Sheets can be accessed with the help of Google Apps Script. So in Google Sheets we have rows and columns, so it is very easy. But if I talk about Google Slides, we don't have any rows and columns, so we have to locate our text box with the help of HTML code, which we are going to learn here. So before that, I'll just create one slide variable. Okay, all slide variable, and I'll call slides app. Application is the communicator between me and the slide. I'll put dot and then get active presentation. Whichever presentation is active, it will take the data for that presentation. Now I know I got the active presentation now. Now I want all the slides here. For example, there are multiple slides here. Okay. Now I want all the slides in one variable so that I can locate the slide. For example, in this case, the first slide is the slide where I want to make the edits, right? So I'll go here. I'll ask for the slides. I'll create a variable here. All slides dot get slides. Bracket close, square bracket, and put 0 in this. 0 means the first slide, because whenever you store, you call the presentation and you call the get slides function, it will bring all the slide numbers, but it will not start from 1, it will start from 0. So I want to make edit in the first slides, that's why I am putting 0 here. Okay, now with the help of this line, I accessed the first slide. Okay, now what I have to do is I have to locate the element. So I'll just go here. I want to locate this element in this particular slide, so I'll just right click over here on the top, go to inspect, click on this button, select an element in the page to inspect it. I'll click this and then I'll hover on the text box like this. I'll click this. So this is the exact line in the HTML code. So I have to go up in the code. Okay. And I have to get the ID, the first ID, which is visible. I'll just copy the ID content. I'll close this and I'll come to the code, double lines, and just put the ID. So these double lines is basically commenting out whenever this function will run, it will not consider this line. So that's why I have forward slash here. Okay. Now I got the element ID of the text box. Now I want to access the text box, right? So I'll just write content slides dot get page element by ID. And the ID will be after this hyphen. This is the ID. not the complete one, right? So I can put the ID directly here, or I can create a variable as well. So in this case, I'm putting the ID directly. Dot get as shape. Okay, cool. So I'll just write content or get text. Okay, so this line I'm talking about, go to that slide. In this slide, this is the first slide. Go to the slide, get the page element by ID, which we found out with the help of HTML code, this, and get the shape. Okay, and then after that, go to the content. Content means this. Go to the content and get the text inside that particular box. Now I got the text. I will write text dot set text as, for example, in this case, I'll just write to and save. Okay, so what I'm doing is I am calling spreadsheet app and I'm asking to go to the active presentation. Then in that presentation, I'm calling all the slides in a variable here in an like an array, and I'm accessing in this code. I'm accessing the first. I want to access the first slide, which is number 0 in the array. Then I'm saying go to this slide, the first slide which I selected, go to the page element ID. This is the ID of the element, get it as a shape, and then in that shape, get the text inside it, and after getting the text, set the text as this. Okay, I'll just save it and I'll run this. Before running, I'll just show you the content. It is 08/01/2022. Come here back. I'll just run it. It will ask me for the permission. I have to give the permission before running the code. Review permission. Click on this. Advance. Go to untitled project. And allow. Once you have given the permission, it will start. And I'll just go and check. It should be changed to 08/02/2022. And see, the text has been changed. Right? If I go and change the date to 10th August, I'll just run it again. I'll come here and the date will get changed here. See. So this is a very simple concept which I have explained. If you have any other complex creation out there, let me know in the comment box. I'll help you out. This is a very, you can say this is a very simple code. You can do a lot of stuff here. You can auto-populate the current date in here. You can get the current date with the help of Google Sheets. If your data is present in Google Sheets, you can pull the data here and you can paste the data here as well. I hope you understood the concept and I hope you liked my video. Thank you very much for watching.